Am I right? That's a chair, sir. Can you hear me? Okay, I have the.
Yes, sir, yes, sir. Yes, thank you very much.
Mr. Chair, sir, thank you for joining us. And Professor Hassan, as I talked earlier, he'll be talking about COVID-19 reshaping the world. Can it be a positive catalyst for ecological sustainability and sustainable development goals? A case study from Goa. Over to you, Professor Hassan, sir.
Thank you, Doctor. Thank you, Dr. Zatakhan Shumari, for playing an instrumental role in the organization of this important workshop. As we all know that in January 2020, the COVID-19 virus started to spread from Wuhan to other parts of the world. And the number of those affected and those sadly dying began to rise at 20-30% in many parts of the world. As a result, the global community starts immediate actions to mitigate and adapt to reduce the pandemic risk in groups. Number first, strongly reduce social and institutional gatherings, their substitution by virtual gatherings. The global community also reduced traffic and travel strongly, and the global community reduced in-person consumerism as transformations to virtual purchasing home delivery. Then business, civil societies, NGOs moving to virtual communities. There is change occurring in agricultural activities, there is change occurring in the forestry activities, because many know that the source of the virus is bats, and that is even in this either in agriculture field and in forestry. Then there is serious change occurring in the detection systems of the world in general and in Pakistan in particular, like moving toward online classes, changes in healthcare system occurs, non-emergency care going online, while the COVID-19 intensive care department pushes many health systems to take a point behind. A missing dimension so far in the response has been lacking of a large-scale community health workforce to address the health issue of isolated vulnerable people's pre-hospital conditions of affected cases. And finally, there is a change in the global and national flow of material goods, along with changes in global and regional relationships amongst the country. The global efforts to slow the spread of the coronavirus has brought with its growth business a major expansion of working from home, other visualized activities, including retail shoppings, delivery services, a quickly escalating economic slowdown that is now affecting billions. It is also certain to shrink greenhouse gas emissions this year. As well as dealing with climate change, there are also clear imperatives to reduce the risk of future pandemic and economic disruption. The impact of COVID-19 on global economy in general and on the economy of Pakistan in particular is not currently known, but could be a loss of at least 5% of the global GDP. In disaster risk reduction terms, they're spending 10% of this impact. It means 0.5% of the GDP would be readily justified. If it would significantly reduce future pandemic risk and add to existing commitments of 3.8% of the GDP per year to deliver the Paris and SDG agreements of the global community. Incorporating one into the other could save at least 0.5% of the GDP per year. COVID-19 pandemic impacts on food and agriculture. This has seriously affected both youth and livelihoods, and the global food emergency that would have long-term impacts on hundreds of millions of children and adults. According to the UN estimate, as many as 132 million may go hungry by the end of this year's 2021 as a result of the economic recessions triggered by this pandemic. So unemployment rates, income losses, and rising food costs are jeopardizing food access in developed and developing countries, like will have long-term effects on food security. COVID-19's pandemic have impact on food and equally urgent is the compounding threats of the pandemics on existing crises, such as conflicts, natural disaster, climate change, pest and animal diseases that are already stressing our food systems and triggering food insecurity around the globe. Recently integrated food security phase classification analysis pointed to a worrying deterioration of acute food insecurity in countries already suffering from other crises. To avoid a food emergency, there is an urgent need to protect the most vulnerable, keep global food supply chains alive, mitigate the pandemic impact across the food system, building back better, more resilient food systems. And we all know that food security by definition is the physical and financial access upon member of the community to sufficient and quality food is food security. So this, the diagram shows that there is availability of food. So before during the normal routine circumstances, the food security, there is food available, there is consumption, there is production, so food supply is ensured, accessibility is ensured, and the food demands is also in place. But during the pandemics, these relationships become narrow and narrow. The food demands is the same, but the supply is reduced. So the food insecurity risk is increasing in many parts of the world, especially in developing parts of the world. How should we support farmers in order to prevent the health crisis becoming a food crisis? To support farmers, it is important to allow movements of seasonal workers and transport operators across domestic, international, and international borders. Another good factor would be to identify collection centers closer to producers and to allow local market to remain open while putting in place physical distancing measures within and outside market. If feasible, relocate markets to larger premises while ensuring the food infrastructure is in place to maintain quality and food safety. COVID-19 pandemic disturbances on consumption of agricultural and food products. Population suffered from loss of income, unable to afford food for their daily needs. Number second, vulnerable groups are the most at risk. In Pakistan in particular, and in the northern parts of this country in special. Impacted by possible increase in the price of food, and in the country level, food imported country forms greater risk due to shock in international trade and currency exchange fluctuations. What seems to estimate the risk of exposure, shares of food expenditure per capita, and shares of agriculture in form. For keeping food value alive in COVID-19 pandemic, agricultural-related sectors remain exempted from lockdown in Pakistan. High or shock on production factors, low availability, and or high prices of agricultural inputs, lower yields, decreased supply, further affecting producing fertilizers, farmer get sick, logistic bottleneck, etc., etc. Practice to estimate the risk of exposure, share of intermediate inputs, consumption of fixed capital for agricultural workers, gross output for agricultural workers, share of agricultural exports. This is the example of district swap in Pakistan. You see that before the COVID-19, the people were normal. They get some handsome returns from the sale of the peaches, eggs, and the presents. The food swap in the country is defined as a food basket. So the peaches during the COVID-19, this one diagram showed that there was 70 to 80% losses during the COVID-19 as per the data of the agriculture department. So this has affected not only the monetary returns to the farmer community, but has also increased the food insecurity among the public at large. So socio-economic and environmental impact, assessment of the consistent socio-economic and environmental impact of the COVID-19 pandemic strategy for mitigating adaptation of future pandemic climate change risk. At present, we are known that this world faces three overwhelming threats of global disaster climate change. Number first, number second, the coronavirus pandemic unknowns and transformative socio-economic changes in its aftermath. So some of these socioeconomic changes have positive effects in support of climate change mitigation adaptation. Use existing models, data, and see to analyze through a system approach what these beneficial socioeconomic changes may be under various scenarios to be applicable from December 2029 up to 2050 and beyond. This is the preliminary findings of our study. We are still working on the projects, especially in this district's part, and we hope that this study will be replicated in other parts of the country. So initials and preliminary conclusions is steering stimulus funding to enable Pakistan to take a system approach towards the policy number first, to the economics and to the finance insurance. So that will reduce and mitigate adapt to future pandemic climate risk. Therefore, it is recommended to have look to the origins of COVID-19, how it spread, what factor draw it in high part of high infection death rates. So thank you. I will conclude my very short presentation with these few slides. Thank you once again for giving me the opportunity to talk in this high learning forum.
Thank you very much, Professor Rastchev. Thank you for sharing a very interesting perspective with regards to the food security challenges faced by different segments of the society and giving an insight into the economic perspective of this whole pandemic crisis we actually faced, especially during the last 1.5 years. Now I